The Los Angeles Lakers have had a difficult season, to say the very least. Before the season began, they were pegged as championship favorites, as any team featuring LeBron James would be. Unfortunately for Lakers fans, it did not come to fruition as anticipated. The team is only 16-14, and owing to the fierce competition in the Western Conference, they will have to fight for the top 6 slots. If they finish 7th or 8th, they will have to compete in a play-in game. Anthony Davis is one of the reasons why the Lakers are struggling. While it's not widely held, a probable Davis deal may provide the Lakers with the help that they require. Here are two reasons why the Los Angeles Lakers should trade Anthony Davis. First up, accidents and dependability. The first reason is self-evident. While it's understandable that AD does not wish to be injured, it is nonetheless a significant concern. The unibrow has only missed 3 games this season, but he will be out for the next 4 weeks due to an MCL sprain. This is a crucial part of the season for the Lakers, as they need Davis on the court to help them. They presently sit in 6th place in the Western Conference, but the Nuggets, Mavericks, and even the Timberwolves are all within striking distance. The Lakers face critical matchups against the Timberwolves, Grizzlies, Suns, Nets, and Nuggets over the next 4 weeks while Davis is away. While there are some easy games here and there, the majority of these teams are either direct playoff challengers or championship contenders that the Lakers must overcome in order to win the championship, which is the team's ultimate goal. If Anthony Davis is out, the majority of the burden rests on James, who is 37 years old and playing 37 minutes a game. He will almost certainly approach the playoffs exhausted, and it will become further clearer how Davis cannot be counted on. How can the Lakers rely on Davis if he's having problems now, as his workload increases as the playoff race heats up? This is a major topic that Coach Frank Vogel and the rest of the team must address. Once again, it's not entirely Davis's fault if he continues to be hurt. Some of the responsibility may go on him and his conditioning, but the vast majority is simply terrible luck. That is entirely immaterial for the Lakers, as they require a second star on whom they can rely. He continues to miss time, and if he does so in a crucial playoff game, the Lakers' title dreams will be over. Anthony Davis from the Pelicans, who had a significant drop in efficiency and play during his first season with the Lakers, is not the same AD that we see now. When he arrived in LA in 2019, he was a complete player who had only recently added the 3-point shot to his arsenal. Davis averaged 28 points, 11 rebounds, 2.6 blocks, shot 53% from the floor, and placed 3rd in MVP voting in his second to last season in New Orleans. When we compare it to this season, we suspect that something happened in the interim that had a significant impact on Davis. Of course, one could argue that he joined a new team with LeBron and other capable players, and that he does not have to carry as much. Davis, on the other hand, was reasonably close to his Pelicans averages in his debut season with the Lakers. He finished with 26 points, 9 rebounds, 2 blocks, and a 50% field goal percentage. That isn't far off from his finest season in his career, which was in New Orleans in 2017 through 2018. He gradually lost his touch, and it shows when he plays for LA. Injuries were most certainly a factor, but it is likely that it goes beyond that. AD appears indifferent at times, as if he's not totally focused on the game. That was not what the Lakers intended, and while he did win a championship in 2020, the Lakers fans and organization wanted Davis to gradually take over the reins from James as he aged. Right now, it appears that James is still carrying this club despite his age and, more regularly, ailments. Anthony Davis has contributed a lot to the Lakers, and he was a big reason why they won the championship. However, before it's too late, the Lakers must recognize that Davis will not be the franchise's leader as James slowly rides off into the sunset. He's a fantastic player when healthy, but definitely not as good as he was a few years ago. Trading him now would offer the Lakers at least some value, and they should consider it. Some believe that Russell Westbrook might be available in a trade, but LA is in dire need of playmakers. Plus, Russ is having a quietly good season for the Lakers, outside of a couple hideous games. Why would they get rid of the triple-double machine instead of a big man who hasn't proven that he can stay healthy and on the court? Only time will tell what the Lakers do in order to bounce back from this disappointing start at the end of LeBron's career. But what do you guys think will happen? Will Anthony Davis stay in town or get shipped out? Who could he get traded for? Could we see Russ or Talen Horton-Tucker traded away? Or will the Lakers retain their current roster? Let us know in the comments section down below. Well guys, thank you so much for tuning in. Be sure to smash that like button, subscribe to Sport Inc., and hit that notification bell so that you never miss a video. We'll see you guys next time.